Hi Taurus, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your personal life or your work life, you may write to me for a personal consultation to tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Taurians, it's a slow month, it's a quiet month, and I think all of us are in a way grateful for that. We have enough that is going on with the virus that has just taken everybody by the suddenness of the way that it is spreading is, and the devastation along with it, which is it is causing globally, has just taken, I think, everybody's breath away. Uranus, of course, is at play. It carries on being so till about 2025, and it's causing its havoc. It's just getting in, doing its bit of it, shaking things up. I think it's also a time where Uranus, along with Pluto, we also have Pluto at play. Pluto tends to bring up everything that is there underneath the surface. It tends to bring out things that we've long forgotten about, things that we do not want to face. And Uranus comes about very swiftly. It gives suddenly, it takes suddenly, but the entire unpredictability bit of it, and also because it rules the, it's very dynamic, it rules the internet, it rules the web, you know, so things, communication, things which are moving around faster, that is something which Uranus rules. While of course that is the I think the larger part of what is bothering and affecting all of us, and quite drastically, I think especially the senior citizens, the older people, you know, who are more susceptible to this. The month of April, planetarily, it's fairly quiet before the May and June begin with the Venus and the Mercury retrograde. Yes, I know we perpetually seem to be in a Mercury retrograde. That starts. But I think let's take this month as a solitude. Let's take this month of gratitude. To be grateful for things that we have. We have our family, we have a roof and on our head, and I think there's just so much to be grateful about. There's a lot of focus, Taurians. It's your birthday month, happy birthday, and so a lot of focus is there on you, your dreams, your desires, your goals. It's pretty much that you're resetting the clock on your wishes and on your desires, and what is it that you really want out of life, how it is that, where it is that you see yourself, where it is that you want to go as far as your personal and your work life is concerned. We will also have Venus, that is your ruling planet, in your own sign as the month opens up. So it's for the couple of weeks, it's a great time to be, you know, if you want to sort of do something nice for yourself and, you know, do something wonderful for yourself. I think if you've been waiting to read that book, take some time. You know, just sort of chill at home, take care of yourself, read those books, stay late, you know, wake up later in the morning, just indulge yourself a bit this month. On the 4th, we have then Venus, and she's moving into your house of money, and this is a lovely time. So again, it's a great time to be, because it's a house of money, it's talking of doing things that you really love. Growing your money very lovingly, being appreciative of what you have, being really grateful towards money. I think a lot of times we tend to take things for granted and saying, yeah, you know, I'm working, I get the check, so what's the big deal? But I think this entire month also is a time of showing a lot of gratitude, and especially because Venus is there and she's all about beauty, love, sex, and money. A lot of, while you will be thinking about ways how it is that you can grow money, but it's a wonderful time for you to be going back to things that make you happy. So if you have a passion for theater, so if you have a passion for singing, I think maybe it's a time that you can indulge yourself and really look at that passion more seriously and invest some time. And again, you know, I firmly believe if you truly follow your passion, money comes. So go back to things that you really used to enjoy doing. On the 8th, we have a full moon that is there in your house of work and your house of health. So listen to your body this month again, Taurians. Are you getting tired very quickly? Are you feeling irritable? Are you exhausted? What is it that the body is trying to tell you? I think a lot of times, and again, this is something I firmly believe, that we can lie, we can verbalize and we can say things, we can communicate, oh, I'm not feeling, or the mind can play tricks, but the body does not. So learn to listen to your body. And at times it's almost like a physical reaction also to things that we have, to people. In fact, we just don't feel very comfortable amongst, certain people, even though they may not have done anything to us, but it's just a vibe that is like, you just feel, oh, I don't think so. I can be around that person for a very long time. It just isn't, his or her energy just does not work for me. So I think listen to your body, listen to what is it that it is trying to tell you. Be patient with yourself, and also look at your, if you're working from home especially, take a look at your home environment or take a look at your work environment. Make it more conducive, make it more, and especially if you're at home or at work, ensure that there's some green plants, fresh green plants that are there. It will make you feel really better. On the 12th, we have Sun, which is joined by Mercury, and they are moving into your house of behind the scenes. So this is again a time of introspection. I think you are you're looking at things, maybe childhood patterns, they may come about. Maybe you could be looking at your earlier part of your life, and you could just be doing a comparison and seeing as to how far I've come. It's also a time of spiritual healing, Taurians. It's a time of sort of being very gentle with your soul. It's taking care of yourself. And somewhere we need to understand and know as individuals, what is it that I really connect with? And irrespective of, a lot of people are connecting with it or not, what is it that really makes me happy? So go within yourself. See what is it that, really makes you happy from inside. So if you enjoy taking those lovely long solitary walks, if you love going for a long, ride on your bike alone, and that is what sort of just sets you, your soul flying, then do that. Try to listen more, I think, externally and internally to yourself this month. On the 20th, we have Sun, our birthday time. It's moving into your own sign. And on the 23rd, we have a new moon that is there in your own sign, Taurian. So beautiful time to be setting your goals, putting your resolutions. What is it that you want for yourself? Doing like a pro and a con, doing like a checklist of things that you want to do, where it is that you want to go. I would say overall, utilize this quiet time. Utilize this time to listen to your inner self. Be very selective of the content that you're consuming. I think that's so important in today's day and age. And also, I think these things subconsciously really impact us. Eventually, we are who we are, basis the kind of content or the thoughts that we think. Keep that in mind, this month, audience. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I'll see you again next month, and thank you so much for watching.